Children, welcome to sociology class. Our today's topic is social movements. It is a part of the unit social change. So let us discuss the meaning of the word social movements. We all live in a society, and in the society a large number of changes have been brought about by efforts exerted by people individually as well as collectively. Such efforts have been called social movements. A social movement may therefore be defined as a collectively acting with some continuity to promote or resist a change. So here two words are important. Either they are to promote a change, or second is to resist a change in the society or group of which it is a part. So let us discuss some of the definitions given by the sociologist. The first definition, according to Anderson and Parker, social movement is a form of dynamic pluralistic behavior which progressively develops a structure through time and aims at partial or complete modification of the social order. So it points out the pluralistic behavior, means a group behavior which aims at complete modification of the social order. It may be complete or it may be partial. Then the second definition by Lundberg and others, they define social movement as a voluntary association of people engaged in concerted efforts to change attitudes, behavior and social relationships in a large society. So we can say that social movement is the effort by an association to bring about a change in the society. A social movement may also be directed to resist a change. Some movements are directed to modify certain aspects of the existing social order, whereas others may aim to change it completely. So it includes complete or partial modification, or it may be of resistance. So the former are called reform movements and the latter are called the revolutionary movements. Social movements may be of numerous kinds, such as religious movements like Sikh movement, reform movements like civil rights movement, or revolutionary movements like Indian National Freedom Movement. Some examples of social movements are movements to save environment, current topic, then movement to save wildlife, fascist movement, communist movement, tribal movement, Dalit movement, civil rights movement, women's movements, etc. So all these are the examples of social movements. So they are either to resist a change or to promote a change, may be complete, may be partial. Now our next topic is, what are the different causes of social movements which lead to these movements? Social movements do not just happen. It is the social unrest which gives rise to a social movement. The social unrest may be caused by these factors. We shall discuss them one by one. The first factor is cultural drifts. The society is undergoing constant changes. The values and behavior are changing in all civilized societies. In the course of cultural drift, most of the people develop new ideas. to get these ideas operative in society, they organize a movement. The development of a democratic society, the emancipation of women, the spread of mass education, the removal of untouchability, equality of opportunity for both the sexes, then growth of secularism, all these are the examples of cultural drift. Then the second cause is social disorganization. We see that a changing society is to some extent disorganized because changes in different parts of society do not take place simultaneously. One part changes more rapidly than the other, producing thereby numerous lags or gaps. Industrialization has brought urbanization, which has in its turn caused numerous social problems. Social disorganization brings confusion and uncertainty because the old traditions no longer form a dependable guide to behavior. The individuals become rootless and they feel isolated from the society. A feeling develops that the community leaders are indifferent to their needs. The individuals feel insecure, confused, and also frustrated. So this frustration, confusion, insecurity feeling, it produces social movements. So it is the result of social disorganization due to some changes in the society. Then the third main cause is social injustice. When a group of people feel that injustice has been done to it, they become frustrated and also alienated. Such feeling of injustice provides fertile soil for the development of these social movements. The feeling of social injustice is not limited to the miserable poor. It may occur in any group, at any status level, may come to feel itself the victim of social injustice. So it's not a matter of only the poor section of the society. It may occur to the rich section also. Like a wealthy class may feel a sense of injustice when faced with urban property ceiling act or high taxes intended to benefit the poor. Then they feel the social injustice. Social injustice is a subjective value judgment. A social system is unjust when it is so perceived by its members, like reservation policy. Some favor it, but some think that it is a type of social injustice. Another example can be given of Dalits, right? Dalit movement took place due to the injustice which was being done by the Dalit people, or which they were called the untouchables. So we can say that the social movements arise wherever social conditions are unfavorable. It may be noted that in a stable, well-integrated society, there are few social movements. In such a society, there are very few social tensions or alienated groups. The people are contented, but in a changing and continuously disorganized society, the people suffer from tensions. They are not fully contented. In such a society, they perceive social injustice and become dissatisfied. Means social unrest. It is the dissatisfied who build social movements. Means the group of people who are feeling dissatisfaction by the system or by any injustice, they lead to social movements. The modern society is more afflicted by social movements. So here we have discussed the three main causes of social movement. The first is cultural drift. Second is social disorganization, and the third is social injustice. Now, let us discuss some of the characteristics of social movements. First characteristic is it is a collective action. Social movements involve collective action of the whole group, and this collective action between a movement comes only after sustaining for a long time, and large number of people are involved in this type of social movements. So it is a collective action. Then second characteristic is it is oriented towards social change. Most of the social change social movements bring some social changes. Then ideology behind the movement. Always, if there is any social movement, there is always some specific ideology, and it is oriented towards a change. Then organizational framework. The social movements require a minimum organizational framework to maintain a speed or a tempo of the movement. And lastly, we can say that a social movement may adopt its own strategy to achieve its goal. Every social movement has a different strategy. So these are some of the characteristics of social movements. Now, in the last, we shall see what is the role of social movements in the society. A social movement is an organized activity that influences social change. It is very difficult to define social movement precisely, as scholars consider this from their own viewpoints, which range from socio-political activities organized by social groups to a historical trend affecting more than one aspect of society as a whole. The term social movement has been popularized in the early 19th century. This was the period of social upheavals. The work of Rudolf Hebril, Niels Melster and John Wilson have important contributions to the concept of social movement. Social movements occur in all the societies, as people can never be completely satisfied with the resources and facilities available to them, neither with the method of its distribution and consumption pattern, especially in societies which have to accommodate forces of modernity with the existing traditions of indigenous local society. The conflict of interest is more. In India, the rate of social movements is high because it is a pluralistic society. In the beginning, there was a long tradition of Brahminical hierarchy. Most of the people remaining in the lower rung of the social structure are docile and fatalist, because they were thinking that it is our place and we will remain in the same place forever. But after pre-independence and post-independence period, means before independence and after independence, some changes took place. The people have started raising their voice against the superiority of the Brahmins, and it gave the shape of Dalit movement. So people always want some changes, and when it becomes the voice of many people, so many people get involved, then it gives birth to social movement. So the nature and extent of social movements in India in recent years show a trend in which the claim for peace and security, rights and stability, availability of resources and careful utilization of the same are being visible. So the nature of social movements in different eras. In the same way, the extent of social movement is also different in different periods. Somewhere it takes long time, but sometimes it gets a different shape within a short period of time. Some sociologists are of the view that protest and agitations in post-independence India are the result of the conflict between tradition and modernity. The scholars who adhere to the theory of political development considered that the aspiration of the people is not adequately met by existing political institutions, which are rigid or incompetent. As the gap widens between the two, political instability and disorder leading to mass upsurge increase. So there may be different causes, but they always lead to some changes. Social movements are attached with social changes. Sometimes the social changes cause social movements, and sometimes the social movements cause social changes. We cannot say that social movements always bring the solutions to the problems. It happens, but not always. Sometimes when the social movements take place, they increase the social problems. But sometimes the social movements solve the problems. So it may happen in both the ways, in a positive way or in a negative way, but it is seen that always the social movements bring changes in the human society.